Today we are going to do an activity electric circuit with switch. In this activity we need a base. So this is the base, and here you can see the circuit diagram printed on this base. We also need one bulb holder. This is the bulb holder. We need one bulb. So this is the bulb we need in this activity. One switch, wire, battery cap, 9-volt battery, screws and screwdriver. So let's start this activity, and before we can make this activity, firstly let me tell you more about the components which we are going to use in this activity. So this is called the battery cap. Whenever we are talking about the battery cap, battery cap is a two-terminal device. So here you can see this is the two terminals of the battery cap. The red wire is the positive and the black wire is the negative terminal. This is the universal law. The red one is positive and the black one is negative. So this is the battery cap. And we will also use one 9-volt battery. This 9-volt battery is again the two-terminal device, positive and negative. It is also written here, the plus sign. Here, the plus sign indicates the positive and the minus sign indicates the negative. And one of the most important component in this activity is a bulb. Let me tell you more about the bulb. So, in this bulb, we have two terminals. This black color is the terminal, and here also we have terminal. So the bulb is a two-terminal device, and after that this is the metallic body of the bulb, and this outer casing is with the glass. And whenever you can see inside this bulb, and you can see there's a U-shaped structure that is called a filament, and the filament is made up of tungsten material. Whenever anyone can ask you the name of the material, then you can say that it is a tungsten. And inside this bulb we have a gas also. That gas is called the argon gas. So argon gas is the noble gas which we use inside the bulb. So bulb is having a two terminal metallic body, outer structure with the help of a glass, and inside this bulb we have a U-shaped structure that is made up of a material called tungsten. We call it a filament. And inside this bulb we have a gas that is called an argon gas. So these are the few important points about a bulb. So whenever we connect the bulb with the battery, immediately the heating effect will take place. As a result, the tungsten material filament start heating and our bulb start glowing. That is the working of a bulb. So let's start this activity, and this is the key for on and off purpose. This is like a switch we have at our home. So in the same type we have this key in this activity. So let's start this activity. The step number one is that we have to fix, or we have to place this bulb holder here on this yellow base. So you have to fix it like this. Make sure the position of this bulb holder must be like this. Right, so in these two screws point we have to fix the screws with the help of a screwdriver. So that is the step number one. So you have to take the screwdriver which is already available in your kit. So you have to take one screw and you have to put it like here, like this. So the main objective of the screw here is to tighten the bulb holder, and you have to fix the bulb holder along with the base like this. And similarly, the second screw you can put it like here, like this here, and you can again tighten it. So let me show you. So in this way tight the bulb holder. right? Like this, you have to place the bulb holder. Now, the step number second is that we have to make a connection, and we have to connect the battery cap positive terminal. So this is the best battery cap positive terminal. It must be peeled like this. So we have to connect this positive terminal of a battery cap at this point of bulb holder. So here we have a screw. So we have to connect this positive terminal of a battery cap with this terminal of a bulb holder. How you connect it? Let me tell you. So you have to change the screwdriver. Now here you can see we have one screw. So you have to loose this screw with the help of a screwdriver like this. Only half you have to loose the screw like this, and then you have to connect. Let me show you how to connect. And then you have to connect the positive terminal of the, here you can see how I'm connecting the positive terminal like this, and then again you can tighten the screw. So in this way we have connected the positive terminal of a battery cap with the terminal of the bulb holder like this, right? Now the next step is that we have this type of a wire. Again, both the terminal must be peeled, or this wire also. Now this wire we have to connect at the second terminal of the bulb holder here in the same way. Just you have to loosen the screw like this, and you have to put any terminal of this wire with the screw of the bulb holder, and then you can again tighten the screw with the help of a screwdriver like this. So in this way we have made the connections like this. Now the next step is that we have to use this switch. So here it is written that key, here we are going to use this switch with the help of one screwdriver. A screw, you have to put screw like this, and then at this point you can fix the screw like this, and again you can use the screwdriver and you can tighten the screw like this, and you have to connect this terminal. You have to connect this terminal with this screw. So here let me show you how to connect. So you have to use, so you have to connect it like this, and then you can tighten the screw with the help of a screwdriver. In this way we have made the connection here. Now the last connection is that we have one more screw. So you have to connect this screw at this point. So you have to put it like this, and again tight with the help of a screwdriver, and connect the negative terminal. Yeah, this is the negative terminal of the battery cap. You have to connect it like this. In this way our circuit is completed. Now the last step is that you have to put the bulb inside the bulb holder like this. So in this way we have completed the circuit. We have connected the bulb holder, key, battery cap all together. In this way we have made the circuit of an electric circuit. Now Let me explain you the working of this circuit. So before I'll explain you the working, let me again tell you all the steps that we have done. We have firstly connect the positive terminal of a battery cap with the screw of the bulb holder, and then we connect the another wire with the second screw or the second terminal of the bulb holder, and we have connected the second terminal of this wire with the first screw of your switch like this. And after that, we have connected the negative terminal of your battery cap here like this. In this way, we have completed the circuit, and at last we have put it the bulb inside this bulb holder. Now let me tell you the working of this electric circuit with switch concept. Let me connect the battery like this. Okay, so here you can see I have connected the battery, but still my bulb is not glowing or not working, because the reason is that my circuit is not completed. In this case, here you can see the circuit is not completed. So whenever we are talking about the completion or the incompletion of the circuit, the two things comes out. One is the open circuit and the closed circuit. So basically, whenever we are talking about the electricity or a current, the electricity is the flow of electrons. So in this case, this circuit is a open circuit. Here you can see I have connected the battery, the current travel like this, and here the circuit is not connected. As a result, my bulb is not glowing. But when I close the circuit like this, immediately the bulb start glowing. So this is the case of a closed circuit, and this is the case of a open circuit. So we have two different type of circuits, open circuit and closed circuit. Open circuit is a circuit in which there is no flow of current. As a result, our bulb is not glowing. And this is the case of closed circuit. Closed circuit means the flow of current or the flow of electrons. As a result, the circuit is completed and the bulb start glowing. So these are the two very important concepts, open circuit and a closed circuit, in this activity. One more important concept comes in this activity is called the concept of switch. So this key will also act as a switch, the same type of a switch at your home. When you switch on, anything can start working, and when you off it, the bulb will stop glowing. So in the same way, when I press the switch, so basically this is the switch, right? When I press the switch, immediately the bulb start glowing. When I off the switch, the bulb stop glowing. So when I press the switch, the circuit is closed. As a result, the flow of electron will take place and my bulb start glowing. When the circuit is open or the switch is off, the current will not flow inside the circuit, and as a result, the bulb will not glow. So these are the two important facts behind this electric circuit. One is open circuit and closed circuit. Second is the switch on and off concept. So in this way, our activity of electric circuit with switch is completed. You can also learn about the conductor and insulator with this activity. Now your homework is that you can study about the conductor and insulator. What is a conductor? What is an insulator? Let me give you a small hint. Conductor means the conductor is a material in which the current can flow. For example, a piece of iron, a piece of copper. This is called a conductor from which the current can flow. An insulator from which the current can never flow, that is called an insulator. For example, a piece of wood. Now you can try at your home and you can see whether the current can flow or not with the help of conductor or insulator. So in this way, we have completed electric circuit with switch. So this is the bulb holder switch. When I press it, immediately the current start flowing, and as a result, bulb is glowing. And this is the off scenario. The current will not glow and not pass, and the bulb will not glow. Thank you.